Well, well, well. Smooth 90.5 FM, broadcasting live on a station that plays the hits. As always, Rob G, Afternoon Drive Show. I have a special, special guest here. He just came in the studio. We gave him a wonderful tour. I'm going to let him introduce himself. His partner was unable to make it, but still, they're both a part of this wonderful event. Ladies and gentlemen, if you don't have your tickets, you got to get your tickets right now. The Gospel Music Awards is this Friday. The kickoff was Sunday. It is going to be held at the House of Hope. No? Christ Universal Temple has been changed. The venue has been changed. And I am so excited to have this gentleman here live on the radio. We are going to have him in here. Ladies and gentlemen, we want to give you a big round of applause for coming out to Smooth 90.5 FM today. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Mr. Barrett.
And we're really excited to be here.
Well, thank you very much for coming and taking your time out. And you have your partner with you, your bodyguard with you, Mr. Quentin.
Quentin Randall is here.
Quentin
with us today.
Randall. So, so, Mr. Barrett, tell me about the Gospel Music Award. I know this is an impromptu interview and everything. The Gospel Music Awards.
Sure, sure.
It's like the Oscars for African America, but in the gospel arena.
That's just what it is.
Tell me a little bit about it.
Well, I'm glad you used that analogy. Certainly, we look at it as this is our Grammy Awards. You know, the Chicago Gospel Music Awards were we actually created the awards to honor and celebrate Chicago-based gospel artists, and we're so happy and elated actually that we have the full support of the Chicago gospel community, not only the artists but the pastors as well. So the pastors have partnered with us, and so have the artists. And you know, the awards were created to celebrate and honor our own, but we own it. All of us take ownership and collectively surround the awards because they belong to the Chicago gospel community.
We are honored to have you here. And we are looking forward to being a part of the Gospel Music Awards and having people listen in on this wonderful event. I know this was the last minute, but ladies and gentlemen, tickets are tickets still available at this present time?
They are. They actually are. They're going fast, but tickets are absolutely available. And you can purchase tickets at brownpapertickets.com.
Brownpapertickets.com. You
right.
Heard that. Come on.
Brownpapertickets.com.
Brownpapertickets.com.
Exactly.
You got to hurry up and jump on it because seats are going real fast. Christ Universal Temple on 119th, right off of I-57. This venue is very huge. This is the former pastor, Johnny
Coleman's
exactly. Yes, church. Dr. Coleman's church is really huge. The parking is very accessible. We're going to let Mr. Barry finish telling you the lineup, the few people that they have lined up for the event, and it's going to be exciting. Can you tell us who's going to be in the lineup for this wonderful event?
Well, it will be just that. It will be very, very exciting. We have Bishop Larry Trotter and Sweet Holy Spirit Choir. We have Dexter Walker and Zion Movement. We have Lemmy Battles, who will be one of our performers on that evening as well. And we are giving three Lifetime Achievement Awards out on that evening. One to Apostle Richard D. Hinton, and another to Pastor Maceo Woods. And the third award is going to Mavis Staples.
Mavis Staples?
Exactly. Mavis from the famed Staples Singers.
Oh, my God.
Exactly.
Wow.
And as a special treat for the evening, coming in to help us to give homage to Mavis Staples will be B.B. Winans.
Oh my
He's coming
God.
In as a guest, and we have Dr. Bobby Jones
okay.
that will be with us on Friday evening, and Morette Brown Clark will be there as well. So there is a host of Moses Tyson Jr. will come to help us to celebrate Pastor Maceo Woods. So we have a number of people coming in from out of town, artists, to help to celebrate Chicago's legacy of music.
Ladies and gentlemen, you have to hurry up and get your tickets to this amazing event. Smooth 90.5 FM will be there live, doing live coverage with the grace and presence and the blessings from the Barrett Media Group. They are the head people. I am sitting in front of the head president of the Gospel Music Awards. I'm excited, and his bodyguard. He's making sure that I'm not going to say anything like, I got to bring my bodyguard up here. But it's exciting. It's, you know, the spiritual is in the air. You have so many gospel artists that it's just going to be mind blowing.
Yes, exactly. Like I said, we have the full support of the Chicago gospel community. So a lot of our presenters are made up of Chicago gospel artists and pastors. So our presenters are some of the greatest names in gospel music that live right here in Chicago.
Does this also tour? Does it go to other cities?
No. We were created exclusively for the home of gospel music, the birthplace of gospel music
here
for Chicago.
In Chicago.
Exactly,
okay.
Right here in Chicago, which is the gospel music capital of the world.
Wow. Amazing, amazing. From me having growing up and having gospel background, from Mahalia Jackson being my godmother and so forth, and my grandmother being the great gospel singer Celeste Scott.
Oh,
who
wow.
Sang,
are you serious?
Sang
wow.
with Mahalia Jackson. They were the original divas.
That's right.
Of gospel.
That's right.
That was
yeah.
my father's mother.
Is that right?
Yes,
that
was
no, that I did not know.
Yes, yes.
Wow.
And I found out that Billy Preston was my cousin.
Are you serious?
Yes, wow. That was his aunt. So my grandmother was
I'm right, like, right,
wow. So
right.
That's where my gospel spiritual realm came from.
Well, that's
so.
Where your music lineage comes from.
Yes,
wow, that's really
a legacy,
great.
You know, gospel, smooth jazz, because I come from a jazz arena.
Sure.
And we wanted to bring it all together, and that's what we want to do with the Gospel Music Awards, to bring an experience where people will understand and know that this is not just a one-time event.
That's exactly right. It is an annual event held every June.
Absolutely. June.
Yes, this is our second award show, but we certainly are going to continue it every year, and we always take place in June.
What inspired you and Ms. Baird to put this together?
Well, you know, we saw that there was, we travel around to many parts of the country, and also to the major music award shows. And we noticed that there was a void that we felt where Chicago gospel artists didn't have a platform to be showcased. And so, again, you know, what better place to do an award ceremony, especially one that is the spotlight Chicago gospel artists. So we felt that there needed to be a platform for Chicago artists, because there's such a deep pool of talent right here in Chicago that we had to create a platform for exposure.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, tickets are going fast. You can go to brownpaperticket.com, pick up your tickets right now. Come on, the tickets are going fast if you want good seats, because Christ Universal Temple is on 119th. It's very huge. Parking is accessible.
Yes, that's right.
And you will come dressed to impress.
Absolutely. It is an award ceremony, you know, and we are in Chicago, so we know how to do it in terms of dressing up. So this is a dress-up affair. And so as you started off saying that this is our Oscars, this is our Grammy Awards. So it was created to be an elegant event, an elegant evening. So absolutely dress up, and then, you know, come on out and enjoy.
So if you don't have your clothes, we know you have your clothes, because you go to the club and then go to church with the same clothes on afterwards. So put those same clothes on that you have and walk the runway. Are they able to walk the runway, or is that strictly for the celebrities?
Well, there is a red carpet event, and we have that for, again, to honor and celebrate our Chicago gospel music artists.